Welcome to church at home. Greetings from Chavez family. Happy Sunday!
Hello, Equipers Manila. Welcome to church online.
Greetings from Abida Lancor.
Welcome to church at home. Happy Sunday! Enjoy!
Welcome to church at home. Greetings from Tejada family. Happy Sunday!
Welcome to Equipers Manila Church at Home. I am Gino.
And I am Sherry, and we are your hosts for today. Equipers Church exists for two reasons. That is to exalt God and to equip people for life through faith in Christ Jesus.
And you know what, Chara? I believe this year is an unstoppable year.
That's right, and we know God deserves our unstoppable praise. So why don't we stand up on your feet? Let's start the praise part.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to church at home, and let's praise God together this morning. Come on, put your hands together for Jesus.
Heaven thundered, and the world was born. Life begins and ends in the dust you form. Faith commanded, and the mountains move. Fear is losing ground to our hope in you. Unstoppable God, let your glory go on and on. Impossible things in your name, they shall be done. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. We're gonna sing it loud. We're gonna shout it out. We know without a doubt our God's unstoppable. We're gonna sing it loud.
We're gonna shout it out.
We know without a doubt
our God's unstoppable.
We're gonna sing it loud. We're gonna shout it out. We know without a doubt our God's unstoppable. Oh, oh,
oh. Unstoppable God, let your glory go on and on. Impossible things in your name, they shall be done.
Impossible things
in your name, they shall be done.
Everybody say yo!
Oh, 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 o
Equippers Manila Church at Home. Before you believe, you already belong.
That's right, Gino. And if it is your first time here, you are our VIP. So you can comment with the hashtag new here. And if you are somebody who invited someone, go ahead and tag them with the hashtag new here.
And to all our VIPs, I would like to invite you to our e-place because we want to know you more. And the messenger link will be provided to you right after the service. And I know you heard about the e-group. Well, e-group is a place where we can empower one another, strengthen each other to be a better person.
That's awesome, and we have the community, and that is the hubs. Whether you're youth, young adults, or adults, we have a special place for you. You can see on the screen the schedule of the hubs.
And to all our kids, I would like to invite you 11 a.m. to our eKids Manila page. So like yung page namin, invite yung mga kids sa bahay nyo.
Awesome, Gino. There's a lot of things happening in our church. And if you want to keep updated, go ahead and like our Facebook page, Equippers Manila.
And not only that, I would like to invite you every Wednesday, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. to our chatbox.ph because we already prepared unstoppable guests to empower you, motivate you, and encourage you. So like yung page namin at samahan nyo kami ni Pastor Ace every Wednesday.
That's awesome, Gino. And once again, today we just started our first physical gathering. And if you are keen and joining next week, just scan the QR code provided on your screen. We have 9 a.m. service, 11 a.m. service for Marikina, and we have 4 p.m. service in Las Vegas.
And I know you're excited to bless our church through our finances. God loves a cheerful giver. In fact, God blessed us with 2 businesses last year. Last year yan, Shara. At naniniwala ko na ganyan din ang gagawin sa inyo, Lord. So, flash on the screen are the ways to give back and bless the church. So, invest and be blessed.
Awesome. So, let's head on to our worship.
And Jesus, this morning, we just want to praise you. We just want to honor you and glorify your name and receive our praises this morning, Lord Jesus, in Jesus' name.
In the darkness, we were waiting without hope, without light, till from heaven you came around. Mercy in your eyes to fulfill the law and prophets. To a virgin came the word from a throne of endless glory to a cradle in the dirt. Praise the Father, praise the you saw to the other side, knowing this was our salvation. Jesus, for our sake you died. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the glory, majesty, praise. that stone was moved for good, for the Lamb had conquered death. And the dead rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe, for the souls of all who come to the Father are restored. And the Church of Christ was born, then the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of all shall not kneel, shall not faint. By His blood and in His name, in His freedom I am free. For the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me.
Unstoppable blessing for everyone, unstoppable favor. In Jesus' name we pray, amen, amen, and amen.
Amen. And now we've come to the most important part of the service, and that is the word. We encourage everybody to put away all of the distractions and get your pen, your Bible, and your journal, and let's head on to the word.
Good day to everybody. You know what? We are so excited for today because today we started our first in-person gathering after 1 year. Grabe, it's been a long time, halos mag-isang taon. And today we started our in-person gathering both in North and in South. This morning, we have a service in El Sueño in Marikina campus. And then this afternoon at 4 p.m. in Cecil's events place in Las Piñas. So we are all excited and we are so thankful to the Lord for providing us a place and for blessing us so that we can gather together. Oh, you know what? I'm so excited and so happy that we were able to gather again. But you know what? Our online gathering, our online church service will still continue because I know that there are a lot of people who still cannot attend our in-person gathering, especially the youth, the elderly, and those people who are watching us online from different parts of the Philippines and from different parts of the world. So on behalf of Equippers Church Manila, we are greeting you today and we welcome you to our church. And so today we got to go to the Word of God, and I hope and pray that even though you are at home, you still have the time and you still have that intentionality to praise and worship the Lord every Sunday. Because you know what? It's not about the place. It's not about the surroundings or the venue. It's all about the heart. And that is why I encourage you, wherever you are, come on, be intentional in getting up on Sunday and praising the Lord together with the church. Maybe it's in person or maybe it's online. So we welcome you today, and I know that you need a word for today so that you can be blessed and you can be inspired and you can be challenged by God today. And God has a word for you today. I'm excited because today we are covering the new series, Unstoppable. And that's what we believe for this year, 2021, that the church is unstoppable. You are unstoppable because we have an unstoppable grace, an unstoppable God. And we're going to dwell on Isaiah chapter 49. And so today we're going to go back on the first verse where we are going to study and where we're going to get all the inspiration or the promises of God. So if you're ready, we're going to read it from chapter 49, verse 7. And this is what God says. Here's the word of God. God, Redeemer of Israel, the Holy of Israel, says to the despised one, kicked around by the nations, slave labor to the ruling class, kings will see, get to their feet, the princes too, and then fall on their faces and homage because of God. Take note of this word. Because of God who has faithfully kept his word. The Holy of Israel who has chosen you. Is there anybody in the house who you are thankful that God is faithful to his word? You know what? I can praise God today because God is faithful to his word. That whatever he promised, he will make sure that he will fulfill it in the name of Jesus. That's why today I'm excited because we are reading an unstoppable word of God. That nothing and no one can stop God's word from fulfilling it. And that is why today I'm going to be sharing to you the word about the unstoppable promise of God. And if you're going to go back to this word, and this Isaiah chapter 49, this is an amazing promise that we can claim for the whole year as a church. Or even not just a church, but personally, it is good I encourage you to read Isaiah 49 in the Bible, and you will find amazing promises from God. As a church, this is the driving force. This is the promise that we are claiming for the whole 2021. So before I'm going to preach the word, I'm going to pray for you and I'm going to pray for the word as we listen to him. Shall we pray? Father God, Lord, thank you, Lord, for your goodness. Thank you, Lord, that you enabled us to hear your word. Thank you, Lord, that we can gather, Lord. And thank you, Father God, that your word is powerful and still will bless and save many people today. So whoever is online right now, Lord, I pray that you bless him, that you bless her and their families, oh God. I pray for protection. I pray for your goodness. I pray for your blessing. And above all, Lord, that they may be connected with you once again, that they may find hope, peace, and joy in you, Jesus. So I pray today as I speak the word, I pray that you bless each one who is listening to this. I pray that he will not stop listening to this broadcast, and I pray that he will finish the message, Lord, so that he will find you, Lord Jesus. I pray these things in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. So today, I'm going to be speaking on the word. The message is no longer restricted by fear. No longer restricted by fear. Can I declare that to you? You are no longer restricted by fear. You have a choice that fear should no longer restrict you. Let me explain about the context of this chapter. Ang chapter na to is that this was given 1,000 years ago to the nation of Israel when they were captives in Babylon. So ang context ng verse na to is that sila ay sinakop ng bansang Babylonia at sila ay dinala sa kanilang bansa. Sila ay mga slaves. They lost their identity as a nation. They lost their identity as a citizen of Israel. They suffered a lot. This is the total lockdown. It's not just lockdown, but they were imprisoned. Some of them were killed. Thousands have died. And all of them were in a different nation, in a different place. And you will wonder in the duration of those years, may kasabihan nga, okay lang na ang suffering mag-last ng isang buwan o isang taon. Pero kung tumagal ng ilang pang taon, that's a different thing. And ito yung suffering na hinaharap ng mga Israelites. They are in a different country and they suffered a lot as a slave. But guess what? The word of God is unstoppable and reaching to them. the preacher who preaches the word. Oh, that's why I am thankful for preachers, for pastors, for Christians who keep on preaching the word even in the hardest times. Because without you, nobody will know the good news of the Lord. And that is why this word reaches the nation of Israel. And here's the thing that was happened. They already settled in a nation where they were slaves. They were just working so hard, and most of them are suffering. And here comes the word of God, the good news, and telling them, the word of God says, saying to the despised ones, saying to those who are kicked around by the nation, saying to those who are slaved by the ruling class, God is broadcasting to them that there's a good news that one of these days they're going to get out of the place and they're going to be set free. But here's the thing, most of them cannot believe the good news. Para bang yung may isang dumating sa'yo na balita na hindi ka pa paniwalaan, is sobrang ganda na hindi nila mapaniwalaan. And I think most of us are like that. God has already given us a good news, and yet we cannot believe the good news. Na para bang we have settled or they have settled on their situation, on their condition. Na para bang sinasabihan na sila malaya ka na. Sinasabihan sila na sila ay free, pero hindi sila maniwala. Kaya ang ginawa nila, ang karamihan sa kanila ay hindi sumunod at sinisip nila na parang imposible mangyari yan. Parang wala tayong pag-asa. Or can I tell you today that there is no situation that you are in right now that God cannot pull you out of it. That there is no situation that is totally hopeless. God's promise is unstoppable. And God is telling you now, get out of that place. You've already been set free. God has already been giving you the promise. And there are two kinds of people that are going to respond to this promise. You either believe it or you either will not believe it. But today I encourage you that when God promises you something, you're gonna believe that it will be fulfilled and it will come true. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm preaching to you right now. I'm telling you the good news that wherever situation you are, whatever situation that you are in right now, God is already telling you that your season has already been over, that this season is now a different one. And God is telling you, you can step out of where you are right now, because you are no longer restricted by fear. You can no longer allow that your life will stop just because of a certain crisis, of a certain situation. You can still choose to live. You can still choose to live abundantly. And that is why the message for today, God is telling them, come on, God is already giving you the good news. And God is saying, God says to the despised one, you got to choose in your life who you're gonna listen to. Are you listening to the world every day, or are you listening to the word every day? It's up to you what you're gonna choose to hear. But here in this verse, God says, thus says the Lord. God is saying something, and the world is also saying something, and yourself is also saying something. It's up to you who you're gonna listen to. But I encourage you that God, you need to listen to the Lord, because God's word is the most powerful thing. If you keep on listening to yourself, you will be depressed. If you keep listening unto the world, you will be depressed. But if you listen to God, you will be blessed. Your direction will change. And that is why I want to declare to you, wherever you are, no longer restricted by fear. You don't allow fear to continually control you. You don't allow the enemy to keep on putting you down or kicking you around. You're gonna stand up and rise up, because God's promise for you is unstoppable, and you are no longer restricted by fear. Most of them decided that, okay, I'm going to get out of this place because God has already given me a freedom. God has already given me a blessing. I got to believe what God has said. And they journeyed from Babylon going back to their nation. Oh, I'm telling you, the moment you listen to what God says and the moment you believe on what God says, you will come out of where you are. You're gonna leave the place that is restricting you and that is keeping you and that's stopping you, and you're gonna go on the direction God has for you. Come on, you are no longer restricted by fear. You cannot allow that your life will stop just because of one season of your life. You're gonna get up and you're gonna rise up because you are no longer restricted by fear. For all those times, for all those moments in your life, you could have been so blessed, you could have been so abundantly blessed, but you allowed fear to control you. I always says the inner me is sometimes stronger than the enemy because we allowed fear to control us. Oh, we decide today, no more, no longer controlled by fear. I will not allow that. I will just be staying in one corner. I will not allow that. I always worried about the future. I'm going to get up because God promised for me something. And I have to be reminded. Okay, hear me now. I have to be reminded that my God that I'm serving is a God who control everything. He is a God who control everything. The world is in His hands. So if this God who controls everything promised me something, then I will believe that what He said is always true and always real. Believe the word, thus says the Lord. Believe the word that God, the Redeemer of Israel, says to you. Believe what God says to you, not what the world is saying to you. Believe what God says. And this is what God said in the verse that He says, God, Redeemer of Israel, the Holy of Israel, says to the despised one, kicked around by the nations, slave labor to the ruling class. This is the time. So that's the first thing that I want to tell you. You can no longer be stopped by the crisis. No longer stopped by the crisis. Oh, this crisis has been crazy. Alam natin lahat tayo ay naapektuhan. But you can decide today that my life will not be stopped by this crisis. I can still live. I can still enjoy my life. I can still enjoy my family because I cannot allow that this crisis will determine my life. Yes, it's a tough time to face this crisis, but you're gonna decide. I will not allow that this crisis will forever control my life. I'm gonna keep on dreaming. I'm gonna keep on dreaming for my family because you are no longer stopped by this crisis. You can get out. You can have life. You can still dream and you can still pursue what God has placed in your heart. You are no longer stopped by this crisis. They were in crisis at the time, the Israelites. Oh, that's worst crisis ever compared to us. I think what they have was worse than us. Mas matindi yung pinagdaanan nila. Pero alam nyo, sa buhay natin, hindi natin kailangan ikumpara ang sitwasyon natin sa iba. Kasi ito lang alam ko, ang pangako ng Diyos ay para sa lahat. Anuman ang pinagdadaanan mo, pwede kang makamtan mo ang kabutihan ng Diyos dahil may pinangako ang Diyos para sa atin. But you can decide today that this crisis, you are no longer stopped by this crisis. The second one that I want to tell you is the word that He said, God, Redeemer of Israel, the Holy of Israel, says to the despised one, kicked around by the nations, slave labor to the ruling class. Not only you are no longer stopped by the crisis, but you are no longer stopped by the hardest situation. What is the situation that you are in this year or the past year that you find it so hard? But look at you now. You're still living, you're still kicking, and you're still fighting. Why? Because of God's word. Because of God who faithfully kept His word. Can I tell you that there is no situation on earth that will separate you from the love of God? God has said in His word that even though they were despised, even though they were kicked around, though they became a slave to the hardest situation, I tell you, this is what I discovered, that the hardest situation can be a condition for a new vision. Oh, I hope you get that. The hardest situation can be a condition for a new vision. Or the hardest challenges can be a condition for bigger dreams. This is a time for us in a hardest situation that we will not stop dreaming. That you're gonna keep on dreaming for something bigger. That these challenges is not a hindrance, but an opportunity for me and for you to believe once more and to believe greater for what have you placed in your heart. That is why you are no longer stopped by this hardest situation. The truth is, the hardest situation prepared you for your greatest breakthrough. Oh, come on, somebody. The hardest situation, if the situation is the hardest, That means that the blessing is the greatest. So I want to tell you, whatever hardest situation that you're in, kapit lang, you can do it because God's promise for you is unstoppable. And there's no hardest situation that you're in that God cannot lift you out of it and He can bless you more and more. No longer stop by the hardest situation. Not only that, but also this. It says in the word, they were despised, they were kicked around, and they were slain. But the crazy thing about this is that God declared that the kings will see and the princes too. Oh my goodness. The kings will see and the princes too. What does it mean? Oh, hear me now. You are no longer stopped by the enemy. Oh, come on, somebody. Whatever the enemy has done to put them down, but they cannot put them out. You may be knocked down, but you are not knocked out. You can still rise up and you can still fight again. But let me tell you the good news. Whatever the enemy has done for your past season, it can no longer work in this season. Because this season is your breakthrough season. This season is your unstoppable season. Oh, come on. The hardest situation is over now. And God is telling you, it's time for you to rise up. Because you can no longer stop by the enemy. Oh, can I tell you that the enemy can try his best, but God's plan for you is unstoppable. There's nothing that the enemy can do to stop God's plan in working for your life. So he says in this word, they may be despised. They may be kicked around. Oh man, it's hard to be kicked around. And they may be slain, but that will never stop God's plan because you no longer can be stopped by the enemy. The truth is, you will only stop if you allow the enemy to stop you. Kung hayaan mo lang yung intimidation ng kaaway na palagi kang dadayain na parang hindi kaya, hindi mangyayari, at takot ang bumabalot sa'yo, kaya hindi ka makagalaw, bawat step mo, ano kaya ganito, at napupuno ka ng takot. Oh, the enemy is throwing fear at you so you can no longer move. Today, you decide by the grace of God. You decide by the power of God that is in you that you're going to rise up today and you are no longer restricted by fear and you no longer stopped by the enemy and you can decide today. The enemy can do nothing against you when you take a stand and use the power of God that is in you. Okay, and I tell you, ang magagawa lang ng enemy ay parang kahol ng kahol, parang aso na gusto kang saktan. Pero let me tell you, ang asong yun ay forever na nakagapos. Dinadaya ka lang na matakot ka para hindi ka makagalaw pero wala siyang magagawa na saktan ka dahil ikaw ay protected ng Diyos. Can I tell you today that you can no longer stop, you can no longer allow yourself to be stopped by the enemy. Go for the dream that God has given you. Go for the calling that God has given you and don't be stopped in any way. And not only that, it says in the word, oh, I love this word. I love this, what it says here. It says, kings will see, get to their feet, and the princes too. Oh, I love this word. What does it mean? Makikita daw ng mga tao kung anong gagawin ang Diyos para sa'yo. I love what it says because on the first word it says, God says, and we will see. Oh, my goodness. What I'm telling to you right now is this. Okay, don't miss this. Whatever God says, you will see. Kung may pinangako ang Diyos sa'yo, makikita at makikita mo. Hindi lang ikaw ang makikita. Pati yung mga kaaway, pati yung mga tao na nag-put down sa'yo, those people who despise you, those people who don't believe in you, those people who ignored you, those people who kick you around, those people who take advantage of you, they will see the power of the Lord in your life. People will see what He has promised for you. Oh, can I tell you and encourage you? If you're undergoing all these things, don't worry. The time will come that you will see what God has said. Because what God has said will surely come true and you will surely see it. What God says, you will see. And even the enemy and those people who oppose you will see it. That is why the next one is, you are no longer stopped by any criticism or by any opposition. Lahat tayo nakaranas na tayo ay hindi pinaniwalaan, tayo nakaranas ng mga bagay na may mga tao nag-despise sa atin. But I tell you, I want to tell you that those things that they have done to you, you cannot allow them to stop you. If somebody did not believe in your dream, so what? It's not the dream that they, it's not them who give you that dream, it is God. So why allow the opposition or why allow the criticism of people to stop you from pursuing what God has given you? What I'm telling you is this, never allow anyone, never allow anything to stop you from your dreams. You gotta keep on doing it. Even so, some people will not believe you, but you gotta keep on dreaming. Because you don't allow, this is the time that you will say, no more. I will no longer allow. I am no longer restricted by fear. I am no longer stopped by the criticism. Because I will see what God has promised. Oh my goodness. That's an amazing thing. And that's why I want to tell you, you don't have to take revenge. Actually, the reverse should happen. You should forgive those people. But when you forgive those people, it doesn't mean that they will still have the say to your life. What I'm saying is that those people, the greatest revenge is the grace of the Lord in your life. The power of God in your life. That is why if you have been despised, let me tell you, you can arise and you can no longer restricted by fear. Because God's promise for you is unstoppable. And the word of God says, let's continue the word. It says, kings will see, get to their feet, the princes too, and then fall on their faces in homage because of God who has faithfully kept his word. Oh, I praise God today that he has faithfully kept his word, even though at times I cannot keep my word. Can you relate to my experience? Ilang beses tayo na hindi natin pinanghawakan yung pinangako natin sa Diyos. Well, I praise the Lord. Now, yung pangako ng Diyos, siya ay tapat sa kanyang pangako. Kaya tayo ngayon nakatayo is because tapat ang Diyos sa kanyang pangako. Oh, come on. Can you just praise the Lord in your house or wherever you are right now na tapat ang Diyos sa kanyang pangako? I am not just preaching here. I am prophesying over you that God is with you wherever you are. And right now, you can feel His presence right now. And you can sense and you are fully feel it and you feel aware of it that God is faithful in your life and He's faithful to your word. But I want to take note what He said, that He has faithfully kept His word, the whole of Israel, because of these last words. And this just amazes me. It says in the word, the one who faithfully kept his word, who has chosen you. What? How can a perfect God choose somebody who has been rebellious in the past, who has been sinful in the past, and who has been despised, and who has been kicked around, and who has been slave? Why choose a slave? You could have chosen, you know, people who are better than a slave. But isn't it amazing that whom the world despises, God chooses? Isn't it amazing that those people that you never thought that God will use, they are the people that God will use? God has chosen the weak things of this world to confound the wise. And God has chosen you and me to be a bearer of His grace, to be a carrier of His grace. And God is telling us today that the reason why you can no longer be restricted by fear because God has chosen you. What an amazing good news that regardless of what happened to you, that is why the last point that I want to tell you is this, you are no longer stopped by your past. Oh, whatever happened to you in the past, you may be slave, you may be despised, you may be kicked around, you may did horrible things in your life, but if you start over again, and you can find that starting over again, not in a reformation, not in your own strength, but only in a person, and His name is Jesus. When you allow Jesus to change your life, you will find a new life. You will find a new hope. Bibigyan ka ng Diyos ng bagong simula at matatagpuan mo lang yun kay Kristo. Ngayong araw na to, whatever happened to your past, God is saying, I have chosen you. And you may wonder, Lord, ba't akong pipiliin mo? Alam mo na ako ay hindi maayos, ako ay nagkamali sa iyo, ako ay nakalimot sa iyo, ang dami kong ginawang pagkakamali at kasalanan, ba't akong pipiliin mo? Okay, I tell you this, that where sin abounded, grace much more abound. Kung gaano katindi ang sitwasyon mo or pagkakamali mo, kung willing ka lang na ikaw ay lumapit kay Kristo, kahit ano pang nakaraan mo, pwede kang patawarin ng Diyos at pwede kang gamitin ng Diyos. Pwede kang piliin ng Diyos. An amazing thing, kung babasahin mong Bible, wala namang pinili si Lord na super perfect o super magaling. Karamihan naman pinili niya yung parang mga hindi karapat-dapat. Alam mo kung bakit? Kasi mas pinapakita ng Diyos ang biyaya niya pag nakikita sa atin na kung sa sarili natin hindi natin kaya, pero sa biyaya niya kaya natin gawin. And that is why today, if you believe that God has chosen you, nothing will stop you. No one will stop you because God's dream, God's promise in your life is unstoppable. And that is why, let me quote for the last one, is that what the King James Version or the New King James Version has said, because there's an amazing word there. If you're going to go to the King James Version, it says there, thus says the Lord. And it says there, thus says the Lord, kings will see, princes will arise, and they will worship. I want to take note that I think that's the pattern that we need to take note here. Thus says the Lord, God says, you will see, and you will arise, and you will worship. Oh, come on, somebody. What I'm telling you right now is when you believe on thus says the Lord, not what the world says, not at what you are saying, not what the enemy is saying, not what the opposition is saying, but you are believing, thus says the Lord. Kung sinabi yan ng Diyos, walang makakapigil yan sa'yo. Thus says the Lord, and it says, kings will see. Look at the pattern. Say what God say, see, arise, and then worship. Oh my goodness. Hear me out. When you believe on the unstoppable promise of God, you are no longer restricted by fear, and you will see in an spiritual eye that you believe that the best is yet to come. You see things by faith. You no longer see, you are choosing not to see the negativity. You are choosing not to see the doomsayers. You are choosing not to see the things that is impossible to happen. But you are choosing to see what God has said. That He said His word. What God says, you will see and you will arise. Oh, I declare today that somebody right now is opening their eyes. The Holy Spirit is opening your eyes. And you will start to arise from wherever you are. In the time of Israel, that's the time that they arose from where they are. And they can say, enough of this. Enough of being in a corner. Enough of being in darkness. I will rise up wherever I am. And I gotta go to what God has said and what He has promised. And I will follow what God has promised. And I'm free. And I'm going to where God says. And it says in the word, what says, you will see, you will arise, but also, especially, you will worship. The point of everything is not just to get the freedom or to get the breakthrough, but the ultimate thing is when you worship. Nothing and no one should stop your worship. Not this crisis, not the enemy, not this hardest situation, not the criticism, not even your past should hinder you from worshiping God. Never allow anything in this time and even at the time that is coming to stop you from worshiping the Lord. Because those who worship the Lord believe that whatever God said, He will fully make it come true. Oh, I'm telling you right now in the name of Jesus that somebody right here, somebody out there, is rising up for wherever you are because you are seeing now what God has promised for you and you are worshiping the Lord because God has faithfully kept His word. Your worship should be unstoppable. Your worship should be unstoppable. Nobody should stop you from worshiping the Lord. And that's why I want to encourage you. This is now the time that you should no longer allow for a long time. You should no longer allow fear to restrict you. No longer restricted by fear. You are rising up and you are rising from where you are. And no one and nothing will stop your worship because God has faithfully kept His word. Right now, I sense in the Holy Spirit, wherever there's a person right out there that is vanquished by fear, that is vanquished by depression, by vanquished by intimidation of the enemy. Right now, I will take this privilege and opportunity to pray over for you. Wherever you are right now, if you can stand your hand right now on the screen, and I want to pray for you that the Lord will release you from any fear that is trying to stop you. It's been a long time. It's now time for you to be set free. Father God, Lord, right now, in the name of Jesus, I pray that the person is extending his or her hand right now. I pray for the freedom that God, you have given to them. I pray that any intimidation of the enemy, whatever the enemy has said to their minds, I pray right now that you release them in the power of Jesus. I pray right now any depression, any anxiety, any kind of fear that is pulling them down and is stopping them from their tracks of following you, I pray that it will all drop down right now. I pray for a miraculous moment right now, right here. I pray, Father God, that whoever is right now is lifting their hands, I pray that he will rise up as a new person, that you have set them free from any fear. I pray right now in the name of Jesus that you are worshiping the Lord. I pray right now in Jesus' name that nothing and no one will stop us from worshiping you. Right now I pray that you worship the Lord wherever you are. Come on. You are seeing now what God has promised for you. And right now, God is releasing you from any fear that you are in your mind. God is releasing you from your past, releasing from what the enemy has done to your life. He's releasing you from what any person has declared over your life. God is setting you free. And God is telling you, come on, worship. You worship me. You don't have to be perfect to worship him. All you get to do is be set free. So today I pray, Lord Jesus, I praise you and I honor you that we are never restricted by anything, not even by the venue, not even by the place, not even by the distance, not even by the time. As the word of God speaks, you can still set people free. Thank you, Jesus, that today we are no longer restricted by fear because we have an unstoppable promise. Every heart, I worship you.
stop working. Never stop.
Come on, he never stops.
Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. Never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Yes, it is, yeah. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. 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 That is who you
And if this is you, for the first time that you have heard this word, about the word of God, about the gospel, about Jesus Christ, this is a promise that He has for you. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should never perish but have everlasting life. Can I tell you that this promise is unstoppable? Nobody and no one, not even the enemy, can stop it. Today, the reason why you hear this word is because He is reaching out to you. He wants to save you. He wants to pardon you. He wants you to become His child. And the way to do it is only by faith. You don't have to earn it. You don't have to work for it. Because if you can work for it, then the salvation is from you. Or you became your own savior. But you are not the savior. Only Jesus Christ is the savior. Whatever comes from us can never save us. It should come from the Lord. It should be the promise that comes from the Lord. And God's saying to you right now, that He loves you and He wants to give you a new life. Can you believe Him today? Can you open your heart today? And if that's you, I want to invite you in a prayer. You can pray with me as you open your heart to Jesus and you believe in Him as your Savior. So here's the prayer. Father God, Lord, right now, I admit that I'm a sinner. I admit, Lord, that I can never save myself and nothing can save me. Lord, I thank you, Lord, that you died on the cross. Thank you that you have given this time, Lord, that I may open my eyes, that you have opened my eyes, that I can see the truth, that somebody loved me and somebody died on the cross for me. Today, Lord, I open up my heart and I accept you as my personal Savior. Today, Jesus, is a new day for me. Today, I am no longer restricted by fear. I am no longer controlled by the enemy. I am a new person and I'm a child of God, as you promised in the Word. Today, Lord, I accept you in my heart as my Savior and guide me in this new life in Jesus' name. Amen. And that's what I'm declaring to you. I want to congratulate you that because of Jesus, you can no longer be controlled by the enemy or by anyone or by anything. You have been set free because of Jesus. So now walk in the newness of life. Because Jesus loves you. And we are here as a church, wherever you are, whatever, in any way that we can help you, please contact us, please message us. We are so willing to bless you and we are so willing to guide you in your new life. So today, for all of us, God bless you Stay victorious, stay happy, and don't allow anything and anyone to restrict you anymore because you have been set free. God has an unstoppable promise for all of us. God bless you.
That was a powerful message. Thank you so much, Pastor John, for reminding us of God's unstoppable promise for us.
That's right, Tara. What a God is. We are no longer restricted by fear.
That's awesome. Now, before we head on to the last phrase, we want to remind everybody, especially our VIPs, that we have created a virtual hangout for you. Gusto pa po namin kayong makilala, so the messenger link will be provided in the comment section.
Wow! What a powerful Sunday! At hindi pa tayo tapos, meron pa tayong praise party!
If it's your first time tuning in at our online Sunday service, then you are our VIP. And we have a treat for you. Join us at our online e-place to know more about this special package made just for our first-time attendees. We would love to know more about you, and that's why we made a virtual space where we can hang out right after our online Sunday service. This will just take a few minutes, so see you there!
Breaking open every tide of mine, your love is spreading out into my life. You take my burden and you make it light. You make it light. Bringing a sound that will break the night. I choose to follow you for all my life. I know that you are always by my side. You're by my side. In everything we do, we choose to praise you. No matter what they say, we will go your way. Dancing to your beat, we can't contain it. We'll never lose as we celebrate. This is how we party, lifting up the name of Jesus. Every moment in your freedom makes me wanna dance. Makes me wanna is spreading out into my life. You take my burden and you make it light. You make it light. Bringing a sound that will break the night. I choose to follow you for all my life. I know that you are always by my side. You're by my side. In everything we do, we choose to praise you. No matter what they say, we will go your way. Dancing to your beat, we can't contain it. We'll never have a lose as we celebrate. This is how we party, lifting up the name of Jesus. Every moment in your freedom makes me wanna dance. Makes me wanna dance. We party, we define the party. This is how we party.